Hi Aquarius, it's Elle here to do a quick reading for you. It's the new moon energy. Thank you for being here. Thank you for liking, sharing, commenting, and subscribing to the channel. It is much appreciated. All links are below if you need to get in contact with me. Let's go ahead and get into it, Aquarius. Thank you, God, for blessing the Aquarius with a clear, concise message from you. So Aquarius, it looks like somebody is maybe in grief, in a state of grief about you. They could be working a lot or trying to work on a plan to get you back. Something is driving them crazy. They want it to stop. Someone could be thinking about you, you know, intensely or just constantly thinking about you. They want to tell you that they miss you. This could have been a person who maybe they did some type of magic, whether it was sex magic or some type of ritual, or maybe they went to a practitioner, or they are contemplating this. This person could even feel like you did magic on them. This is also somebody who did something, said something, just created a lot of havoc in your life, maybe by way of words and wordplay, and maybe even getting with a magical person or a spell worker or a root person, and maybe even doing some type of binding ritual to get you to stop your energy, stop growth, stop moving, stop your money. Maybe now that some of you are in a place of moving forward, you're out of that stuck energy. This person is being bombarded with the guilt that they have to deal with for the bad things that they said or they did, or the magic, whatever. I don't know who you're dealing with, but something is driving them crazy and they want it to stop. It's almost as if they want to come to you and say something to you, but they don't know how. They don't know if they should. They don't know if it'd be well received. They don't know if forgiveness will be had, if you will forgive. It's not your job to release them from this misery, this guilt. And for those of you who are dealing with somebody who did you wrong, treated you unfair, now the feelings have been displaced. How you used to feel, how you used to be sad, upset, crying, distraught. Now maybe they're feeling that in their own way. And now you're feeling a bit of calm, ease. It's like the powers dynamic changing, you know, a power switch. You used to be the one upset, sad, waiting, and now your person is doing it. Okay, that's what I have, like from the shells. All right, let's see what the cards have to say for you, Aquarius. A lot of guilt. I don't think it's on your end. It could be for some of you, you know. A lot of guilt. Like somebody feels so guilty. I don't think you know all of the things that they have done or they said or they try to put in motion. Wow, the Tower. I got this off camera when I was shuffling for you. Page of Cups. All of a sudden, somebody, like I said, once a sudden rush of emotions, or all of a sudden, sudden upheaval of something where someone wants to say something to you, apologize, make amends. It says a surprise, maybe even a surprise message. Good news about business matters. All of a sudden, you get good news. Eight of Cups, they don't like the fact that you walked away. And with your walking away, you took your power with you. You took your power back. You had given it all away. This person could be coming back to you or traveling towards you or some type of visitation or coming to visit you. This person could even talk to you about, you know, maybe even exploring the idea of moving in or making something official. This person is coming to you, firstly, a message coming to you out of the blue, a surprise message. Somebody has really analyzed themselves. Guilt, that guilt was weighing heavy on them. Therefore, they'll give you this exploratory message. I don't know if that's a word, but it's a message just to explore how far they can get with you. And then here comes the speech. Use everything. This says using your words wisely, saying the right things, playing your cards right. A speech to get what they want, to take action into their own hands. It's like they've been lit on fire to come to you and say something. This could be the universe prompting them. This is like a masculine energy. Star card, somebody wants to make amends. This also talks about releasing baggage from previous relationships or just releasing baggage from hurt. Speaking your truth about your emotions and how you feel. This could be you. This could be your person. There's somebody coming back to you. Yeah. Could be a fire sign. Could be a Gemini. Could be a Virgo. It could be anybody. Somebody feels like this relationship is just not finished yet. Someone also could want to make amends with you because they feel like it's not over. They want to work with you. It's like this person is wanting to write something to you, maybe a message or a text message, email, and tell you about how they feel like it's best to be with you. I don't know if this is somebody who chose something else or someone over you. It was a period where you guys weren't talking. There was nothing going on between the two of you. And it was like you started to work on maybe yourself, your wishes, you healed. You got around a new group of people. You started attracting, you know, raising your vibration, attracting your, you know, all that you want to come into your life. It's like you started doing something for you. You may have even changed how you look. You might be putting out nice pictures that start little fires within this person's relationship, if they're in a relationship. This person is seeing your work too. Your work ethic is strong. They're seeing that what you're doing is like you've gotten a rhythm to it. This person could, like I said, want to tell you that they want to come back to you. It works with you. Something just works with you. It feels good with you. It feels like there is balance, or it feels like you're actually, they might want to tell you that it feels like, you know, they're actually creating something with you, something tangible, something worthwhile, something valuable. It's like they want to talk to you, want to write something to you. They don't know what to write. They don't know how to word it. This is somebody who feels like they need to revise their plans or their plan that they have for their love life. This is somebody who thought that somebody else was the one, or they put somebody before you. And now they want forgiveness. They want you to deal with them compassionately, like mercy, grace. Don't fire up on them. It's funny, you got fire in this card. Can you see that? This person really feels like they made a huge mistake. They see your value, your worth. They want to offer you something. They want you to fall in love with them again. They want forgiveness. If you have a family with this person, they want their family back. They love the idea of this. But they know, like, in all of this conflict that they're having in their life, you are the one that they need to end, or some situation, relationship that they're in is coming to an end. All they can do is fantasize about what they want to say to you, how they want to come to you, how they've just been maybe even in a fantasy, like fantasy land. They were engaged in a relationship or something that just wasn't real, and they were trying to make it. They weren't trying to see it. They weren't trying to deal with it. But now they have to. It's like they gain enlightenment, clarity. Now they're making some judgment about somebody or about a relationship that has been dead, destitute, in the dumps, just having no acknowledgement. This is somebody you haven't been with for a very long time. This person sees you as everything, abundant, you know, a walking garden. Like, you just have it all. There's growth, there's prosperity, there's luxury, there's spirituality, there's everything. Expect, this card talks about expect a package, or it could even be expect a message that somebody wants to, they're thinking about you over and over again, and they're trying to figure out how you guys can work. This person could be thinking about you while they're at work. Yeah, thinking about how they can get back in your good graces. What can they say? How you two were just like-minded individuals. How, again, they just want whatever you had previously with this person, they want it back. It talks about the status quo. Maybe the universe separated you and this person so they can fix themselves, and you fix you. Let's see. Yeah. This person didn't choose the soulmate connection with you. Now they're in grief. We talked about that when the reading first opened. It's like, it says the relationship is recoverable, but they don't know what to say, what to do. Look what rests between you two. A river of tears, a sea of tears. All of the drama, everything that has happened between you two. So it's like you have to build a bridge to cross that river. This person let somebody else or something else or a lifestyle or whatever come between you and them. They knew something was significant about the relationship. If they don't subscribe to soulmate, twin flame type situations, they just knew something is very strong. It's a very strong connection, but they still chose otherwise. This person tried to keep the relationship strictly physical. Yeah. And maybe even they gave as little as possible. They always kept you waiting or wondering or asking or feeling like you were begging, not knowing where you stood with them. It was just too much to handle. You know, they could have also, you know, kept somebody else around too. So it was easy to give you very little because they had to give some to the other person, right? So they had to divide themselves. maybe this person showed how they felt with money or by using money. Maybe they gave you money or they bought you something. They never would say how they really felt about you. Now this person is desiring. You're in their heart's desire. It's funny, you got the King of Wands and the Queen of Wands. Something about this relationship could be karmic or was karmic. Somebody got some intuitive downloads about this relationship and they just put an end to it. It could have been you, could have been the other person. Somebody decided to work on themselves. It's like you, Aquarius, you lost yourself in this connection. Because you thought that it had promise. Yeah. You thought it had promise, but this person was playing games. The Emperor. This person has done this for a very long time. Been very cold, been very stoic, been unmovable, unwavering in their thought process, in their life. It's just. It's their way or the highway. They played mind games. It was trickery. It was ego. It was keeping other people involved in the connection. It was, it was just bad blood. All of the games and the lies and the deceptive nature and the self-interest that this person operated in, it just caused bad blood between the two of you. Like, it's just not good. But now somebody wants to, again, offer you, they want you just to fall in love with them again. Like, just fall in love with me, be back in love. They could be seeing the truth of the matter now. They could be seeing the truth, making a head over heart decision, or they used to. This person had high standards or has high standards, but they see you as the viable option. You are the one. Look what fell out. What flipped over. Six of Wands. He has like, they want your attention. They want to give you attention. They want to promote you or propel you. I don't know. Something about choose, maybe even choose. Sixes are choices. They like choosing you. This person, this could have been somebody who maybe resolved to be a bachelor for the rest of their life. Then they met you, they started to feel different about being a bachelor. But then they would play games. There would be mentals. It was other people involved. They scattered their energy because it looks like somebody didn't want to get too serious with you, but now they want to. Yeah, they want a more committed connection. Could be dealing with a Gemini, Taurus. Scorpio, Capricorn, Libra, Aries, Sagittarius, Leo, male, Cancer. Female Cancer, Aquarius, Scorpio coming up again, Taurus, you got everybody. Don't get hung up on the signs. I don't even know. I don't even do that. So that maybe that was for somebody. Now, Pisces also. This person wants a committed relationship now. This person says they were always devoted to you, even if they didn't show it. I don't know if they're saying like you were always the one. A funny way of showing it. Yep. With the Devil card coming out. It's like this person is now, there's a level of addiction. Maybe even addicted to your energy. Codependency. Ego. Flamboyance, exaggeration, just overdoing everything. this energy is making me like the, it's making me like feel depleted. So maybe like some of you just feel like if, well, you, I don't know if you're still in the relationship or you felt like this was taking you to a place of you just didn't have any more to give to this. Like you were just, it's like you were running out of gas, you know, or you are running out of gas for some of you. Yeah, Seven of Wands. It's like, and yeah, this person got a real strong sexual connection to you. They maybe use some type of sex magic, or maybe when you're having sex with them, it's like a telepathic connection. Maybe you hear their thoughts, or you know what to anticipate in the bedroom, or before they even ask, or they say, or they prompt you, or vice versa. This is how they feel about you. This could be somebody trying to get you to talk to them by using some type of sex magic, masturbation, or this is somebody trying to probe. They're trying to penetrate the forces. Penetrate, right? Maybe you've got your defenses up against this. You're done. This is real chemistry in the bedroom. Maybe with a Capricorn, a Leo, it could be anybody. This is temptation too. This is Saturn. Like you gotta learn. This card comes out when two people just haven't learned the lesson as to why you met. It's funny, we have the Lovers, which is the good side of the Devil card, and then we have the Devil showing up. It's like the reason why it doesn't work, because both of you at the same time won't fully accept the reason why you met one another and live in that reason, whatever it looks like. It's like somebody's fighting against the soulmate journey. I don't know if it's both or it's one-sided, but now it looks like somebody's got boundaries up because somebody feels like it's just too much of a hassle, too toxic. Toxic just means unhealthy. The both of you can make the relationship unhealthy, so it doesn't always have to be on one side. Toxic can mean deadly too. Like this could be a spiritual death. Maybe you feel like you keep engaging in this, you're just gonna lose yourself. Somebody's waiting for the opportunity to make up with you by way of, you know, getting back in the sack, having sex. This is how we never break the chain. There's some Fleetwood Mac going on here. It's way too much. I haven't felt like this in a very long time. Somebody just feels like it's way too much. It's just too much. Somebody is in a real high level anxiety state, like a manic type of energy. What is this about? All right, what's the advice for Aquarius moving forward? Seven of Swords, plan in secret. Keep your plans to yourself, revise some plans, but definitely make a plan, right? Know that maybe somebody is talking about you, asking around about you. They're trying to go undetected, unscathed, unrealized. But they're trying to gain knowledge, because the yellow talks about, you know, knowledge, clarity, enlightenment. So they're trying to maybe even get enlightened about you and what's going on with you and your business, the business of you. Yeah, you're not talking to this person, or you guys are not close. It's a lot of trickery. The advice here is keep things to yourself. Plan. I've got another card of planning. Four of Swords, plan for what the future looks like for you, because it looks like the universe is taking you to another higher level with the World card. Universe wants you to have really severed ties with something or someone. It's like the universe giving you this, because the aces are portals to the major arcana, right? So it's like the universe is trying to give you this ace, this clarity, this knowledge. Now, the knowledge that you get, it causes conflict first, right? Because it's new knowledge. Maybe it's something you didn't know or you needed more clarity about, but it causes you to make a decision, an irrevocable change. So that you can then be taken higher. It's like, learn the lesson. You got the devil and the world coming out. It says, learn the lesson, the karmic lesson, cycle closing, learn the lesson. What did you learn in this connection, in this relationship, in this whatever it was you were in? What did you learn about you? What did you learn about people? What did you learn about relationships? What did you learn about your how you react? I mean, start to really dig deep so the universe can bless you with something so much greater, new maturity. What you really want with fulfillment. But they want you to start asking the question, why haven't I had what I really want? You know, they want you to point the finger not at the other person, but at you. What part did you play in this? Is what the cards or the universe is trying to get you to see, so that when they bless you with this immense, this huge blessing, you're ready for it because you did the self-work. That's the advice. 27 minutes. Let's get on out of here. All right, so this is on this new moon. It's like the universe wants a new energy to come into you, and it looks like some really great energy. It's like, really let go of something. Really let go. There's also somebody who's holding on out of guilt, out of, you know, remorse, maybe even resentment on their end. But I feel like that's not your problem. What is the advice for Aquarius dealing with this person who's holding on to them? I heard holding on. What is it? Even though you know that love is gone. Yeah, somebody's still holding on and the love is so long gone. All right, let's see what the advice is for you, Aquarius. The moon card. This person did some shit behind your back. And look, and they gotta carry all of that guilt and grief and emotion and restlessness, and it talks about hidden enemies with the moon card. This could be a Sagittarius, it could be Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, it could be anybody, right? You heard the universe, because this sometimes can be karmic, right? A karmic situation. This is their this is how they're going to make recompense to the universe, to themselves. This is what they deserve. This is their karmic justice. They're getting what they deserve. This person said all kinds of stuff, did all kinds of stuff. Maybe, like I said, you know, even went to practitioners. And now I have to live with that. You know, you put out, okay, so it's only, you know, it's only good and bad, right? There's no in between. And that's why this card just talks about duality. So it's good and bad. Duality is when people feel like they can just continuously go between. I can be good sometimes, I can be bad sometimes. But the God of the universe or whatever you believe in wants us to pick a side and stay true and committed to that side. You're either bad or you're good. You're not both. That's what you're not. Okay? And this person here that's stuck in that grief and wanting to apologize and come to you and say stuff to you and just kind of like fall at your feet, it's because they put out all that bad energy. When you put out anything, it's coming back to you. You do good each and every day. Guess what? Good is coming back to you. Great. You don't know when. You don't know how it's going to show up, but you know, it's there. It's there for you in the reserves, right? And if you put out bad, you know it's there in the reserves. It's showing up whenever. And it seems as if this person has to kind of like pay up. Damn. It's just like, I don't know. It's really hard for me to feel sorry for them in this energy. It's not about feeling sorry because it is compassion. We did have the strength card. It's just more so, this is something you just don't control, Aquarius. I don't know if you know, if you feel it, if you really have wrapped your mind around it, but there was like somebody who was really working against you, like doing whatever they could do to stop you, to halt you, to slow you down, to if you did anything good, if you got anything good, they tried to come against it. It could have been two people or more. It could have been a couple doing this. They got to wear that. They have to deal with this. Wow, this. They're getting judgment. They're getting judgment. Could be someone in your family. It could be anybody. I think you just got clear. This is somebody you're not even like close to. They want to reconcile with you. They feel like that will ease up. You're getting Sagittarius again. They feel like that will salvage the connection and that'll take the heat off of them. Because this person is feeling something. They're feeling a lot. A lot is going on in their life. Shit is not sweet. It could be all bad. They've been called to the carpet spiritually for what they did. I just keep getting, you don't even know, Aquarius, you don't even know what they did. You don't even know what they were saying or what they were doing. Woo, somebody like, I don't know, like your spirit guide, your angel, I don't know. They just want you to know, like you don't even know. You don't even know how serious this was or it is. This person, I don't know who they are. Get a personal reading if you want to know. I don't know. They just kept pounding at this. They just kept doing shit, and it was just like it just kept adding up and adding up and adding up. And some of it took effect on you, some of it did not. And then it got to a place where I'm feeling like there's. You guys are at a place where it takes no effect on you now. and it's not taking any effect on you because they're reaping the rewards, or they're reaping what they've sown. They've sown nothing but negativity, hatred, ill wishes, spellbinding energy. They're getting all of that stuff back. Any final words for the Aquarius? Any final words, I guess? For you to become an expert in whatever you're doing, you got a lot of ambition within you, Aquarius. A lot of ambition, a lot of knowledge, a lot of wisdom. You're capable. You are successful. Things work out well because just the sheer brain power, tenacity that you were born with, just being 10 steps ahead, maybe being a futuristic thinker, has gotten you far. It's opened a lot of doors. But they're saying, look, in order to become this expert in this field or whatever you are choosing, you're going to have to really take some time to yourself, withdraw from the world, and you have to learn something else. You're going to have to learn something, or this is self-discovery. This is changing your personality. You have to learn how to be the boss, clever. You're going to have a surefire plan. You have to be up for the challenge, okay? Whatever this is, it's going to be a challenge. You're going to put a lot of energy behind this, but look what you get if you do it. You get the Ten of Pentacles, you get long-term goal fulfillment, success, achievement, recognition, again, expertise coming out in the Ten of Pentacles. You get a legacy, you get an empire, maybe even a windfall of money, or just longevity in terms of money. This looks like some of you need to do a little bit more research, or you got to get clear on what the vision is and then start to move on the vision, because it can bring you what you're looking for. Some of you, if you get that expert advice or you get someone who can help you, then you'll have more motivation. It's like you're stuck. Maybe due to lack of knowledge or lack of expertise. But once you get it, you move forward. It's like you're trying to make money from or trying to have a legacy that will always maybe generate money. Something you've done or you're doing. It's going to bring you long-term success. This card talks about some of y'all need to let go of something. Let go. You need some help though. You might need help. You might need to talk to somebody about your plans, about what you're trying to bring into fruition. This is an entrepreneur card, so. But look where you go with it, you know. Just happy, organized people build empire. So make sure you're happy and you're organized. Something about getting things in order, self-discovery, clever, 10 steps ahead, mental capacity, something of being sharp, also, you know. You could meet an air sign that can help you. I don't know. This is what I have for you, Aquarius. If it resonates, let me know how it resonates down in the comment section. Go over to the website, book there. Ask a question or two by texting it to the number below. Thank you, Aquarius, for being here. Thank you for continuously showing up. It means a lot. Do like, do share. Let's put some money bags down in the comment section. This is the new moon energy. All things new, all things great. Let's manifest some money corporately. Put that money bags down in the comment section. I don't know, somebody's energy here just is draining. It's freaking draining. Anyway, not yours, but it's like somebody external to the Aquarius, someone external to the reading. It's just like, and then there was an Aquarius who was like high anxiety, like mania. Anyhow, I am live every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday, 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Come to the live, listen to the collective reading, ask a question or two while you are there. If you have a question now, you can text your question to the number below. Thank you, Aquarius. Many blessings to you. Take care.